You are listening to Radio Udaan, Radio Udaan, Radio Udaan, a flight of life. For more information, log on to www.radioudaan.com. Happy listening.
Hello, दोस्तों. Are you looking for positivity and enthusiasm in life? Then don't worry. This brand new show called Inspirational Wings is just and just for you. So guys, to enjoy this beautiful ride with your own RJ Divya, don't forget to tune us every Thursday 9 to 10 only on Radio Udaan.
आप सुन रहे हैं Inspirational Wings RJ Divya के साथ.
गुड इवनिंग, नमस्ते एंड सत श्री अकाल. मैं हूं आपकी होस्ट एंड दोस्त आरजे दिव्या और आप सुन रहे हैं इंस्पिरेशनल विंग्स ओनली ऑन योर फेवरेट रेडियो स्टेशन रेडियो उड़ान. तो चलिए बढ़ाते हैं इस इंस्पिरेशनल राइड को आगे और लेट अस स्टेप इन अवर वेरी फर्स्ट सेगमेंट. Today, the title of our first story is Give It a Thought. Give It a Thought. Father was a hard-working man who delivered bread as a living to support his wife and three children. He spent all his evenings after work attending classes, hoping to improve himself so that he could one day find a better paying job. Except for Sundays, Father hardly ate a meal together with his family, his loving family. He worked and studied very hard because he wanted to provide his family with the best money could buy. When the family complained that he was not spending enough time with them, he responded that he was doing all this for them. But he often yearned to spend more time with his family. Finally, the day came when the examination results were announced. To his joy, Father passed with distinctions too. Soon after, he was offered a good job as a senior supervisor, which brought him good pay. Like a dream come true, Father could now afford to provide his family with life's little luxuries like nice clothing, fine food, and vacation abroad. However, the family still did not get to see Father for most of the week. He continued to work very hard, hoping to be promoted to the position of manager. In fact, to make himself a commendable candidate for the promotion, he enrolled for another course in the Open University. again. Whenever the family complained that he was not spending enough time with them, he responded that he was doing all that for his loving family. But he often yearned to spend more time with his family, his wife and his children. Father's hard work paid off and he was promoted. Successfully, he decided to hire a maid to relieve his wife from her domestic tasks. He also felt that their three-room flat was no longer big enough. It would be nice for his family to be able to enjoy better facilities and comfort. Having experienced the rewards of his hard work many times before, Father resolved to further his studies and work at being promoted again. The family still did not get to see much of him. In fact, sometimes Father had to work on Sundays entertaining clients. Again, whenever the family complained to the father that they are not spending much time with him and he need to spare some time for his family, he responded that he was doing all this for his family. As expected, Father's hard work paid off again, and he bought a beautiful house overlooking the coast of Singapore. On the first Sunday evening, at their new home, Father declared to his family that he decided not to take any more courses or pursue any more promotions. From then on, he was going to devote more time to his family, his children and wife. But alas, Father did not wake up the next day. So friends, the moral is, try to spend prayer time with your loved ones and appreciate the natural beauty around you, because one day you may regret your being over engaged in your work. तो सीखने को हमें यही मिलता है कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा समय अपने लव्ड वन फैमिली और फ्रेंड्स के साथ बिताइए, क्योंकि क्या पता कब क्या हो जाए और कब हमें उनसे दूर जाना पड़े। तो लिसनर्स, गिव इट अ थॉट। तो बढ़ते हैं अब अगले सेगमेंट की ओर, बट बिफोर दैट लेट अस टेक अ शॉर्ट म्यूजिकल ब्रेक। मिलती हूँ मैं आपको इस म्यूजिकल ब्रेक के उस पर। Keep inspiring and keep motivating.
तुम गर हम जाते मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते दर्द दिलों के कम हो जाते मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते कितने हसी आलम हो जाते मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते चाहे तेरा और मेरा हो जाए मुकम्मल ये अफसाना हर मुश्किल आसान हो जाती मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते कितने हसी आलम हो जाते मैं और तुम गर जाते मैं और तुम गर हम हो जाते
जगह ताजमहल के बीचों बीच एकदम केंद्र में है यही सोई है वो ये कब्र है मुमताज महल की और बगल वाली कब्र है उनके बेहद प्यार करने वाले शौहर शाहजहां की
हमारी सांस्कृतिक विरासत एवं धार्मिक स्थल
संपूर्ण पृथ्वी लोक में सर्वश्रेष्ठ स्थान है भारत, और भारत में सर्वश्रेष्ठ स्थान है श्री बद्री धाम, जहाँ पर स्वयं श्री नारायण हर पल हर घड़ी विराजमान रहते हैं।
जानना चाहते हैं इस सबके बारे में? जी हाँ दोस्तों, जुड़ जाइए मेरे यानी गीता सुमन के साथ शो भारत दर्शन में हर शुक्रवार शाम 7 से 8 सिर्फ और सिर्फ रेडियो उड़ान पर, और मेरे साथ कीजिए संपूर्ण भारत की यात्रा भारत दर्शन में, और जानिए अपनी धरोहर, अपनी विरासत, अपने पर्यटन एवं धार्मिक स्थल को सिर्फ और सिर्फ रेडियो उड़ान पर।
तो दोस्तों, अब हम पहुंच चुके हैं सेकंड सेगमेंट में, और इस सेगमेंट में चलिए बात करते हैं एक और स्टोरी की। एंड द टाइटल ऑफ अवर नेक्स्ट स्टोरी इज गॉड कुडंट स्टैंड टू सी मी हर्ट। गॉड कुडंट स्टैंड टू सी मी हर्ट। जेनी जंप्ड अप एज सून एज शी सॉ द सर्जन come out of the operation room. She said, "How is my little boy? Is he going to be all right? When can I see him?" The surgeon said, "I'm sorry. We did all we could, but your boy didn't make it." Jenny said, "Why do little children get cancer? Doesn't God care anymore? Where were you, God, when my son needed you?" The surgeon asked, "Would you like some time alone with your son? One of the nurses will be out in a few minutes before he is transported to the university." Jenny asked the nurse to stay with her while she said goodbye to son. She ran her fingers lovingly through his thick red curly hair. "Would you like a lock of his hair?" the nurse asked. Jenny nodded yes. The nurse cut a lock of the boy's hair, put it in a plastic bag and handed it to Jenny. The mother said it was Jimmy's idea to donate his body to the university for study. यहाँ मैं बताना चाहूंगी, जिमी वो लिटिल बॉय का नाम है। He said, "It might help somebody else." I said no at first, but Jimmy said, "Mom, I won't be using it after I die. Maybe it will help some other little boy spend one more day with his mom. She went on. My Jimmy had a heart of gold, always thinking of someone else, always waiting to help others if he could. Jenny walked out of Children's Mercy Hospital for the last time after spending most of the last 6 months there. She put the bag with Jimmy's belongings on the seat beside her in the car. The drive home was difficult. It was even harder to enter the empty house. She carried Jimmy's belongings and the plastic bag with the lock of his hair to her son's room. She started placing the model cars and other personal things back in his room, exactly where he had always kept them. She laid down across his bed and, hugging his pillow, cried herself to sleep. It was around midnight when Jenny awake. Laying beside her on the bed was a folded letter. The letter said, "Dear Mom, I know you are going to miss me, but don't think that I will ever forget you or stop loving you. Just because I am not around to say I love you, I will always love you. Mom, even more with each day. Yes, I will love you even more each day. Someday we will see each other again. Until then, if you want to adopt a little boy so you won't be so lonely, that's okay with me. He can have my room and old stuff to play with. But if you decide to get a girl instead, she probably wouldn't like the same things boys do. You will have to buy her dolls and stuff girls like, you know. Don't be sad thinking about me. This really is a neat place. Grandma and Grandpa met me as soon as I got here and showed me around some. But it will take a long time to see everything. The angels are so cool. I love to watch them fly. And you know what? Jesus doesn't look like any of his pictures. Yet, when I saw him, I knew it was him. Jesus himself took me to see God. And guess what, Mom? I got to sit on God's knee and talk to him like I was somebody important. That's when I told him that I wanted to write you a letter to tell you goodbye and everything I want to say. But I already knew that wasn't allowed. Well, you know what, Mom? God handed me some paper and his own personal pen to write you this beautiful, affectionate letter. I think Gabriel is the name of the angel who is going to drop this letter off to you. God said for me to give you the answer to one of the questions you asked Him. Where was He when I needed Him? God said He was in the same place with me as when His Son Jesus was on the cross. He was right there, as He always is with all His children. Oh, by the way, Mom, no one else can see what I have written except you. To everyone else, this is just a blank piece of paper. Isn't that cool? I have to give God His pen back now. He needs it to write some more names in the book of life. Tonight I get to sit at the table with Jesus for supper. I'm sure the food will be great. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. I don't hurt anymore. The cancer is all gone. I am glad because I couldn't stand that pain anymore. And God couldn't stand to see me hurt so much either. That's when He sent the angel of mercy to come get me. The angel said I was a special delivery. How about that? And the letter was signed with love from God, Jesus, and the little boy, the affectionate, loving son, Jimmy. So, the moral of the story is that God is always with us, and whenever He sees us suffering through pain or difficulties, He tries His best to reduce it. God couldn't stand us in pain. God couldn't stand to see us hurt. So, dosto, have faith in God and keep moving. इसी स्पिरिचुअल थॉट के साथ बढ़ते हैं आगे और चलते हैं अगले सेगमेंट की ओर, पर उससे पहले वी हैव टू टेक अनदर म्यूजिकल ब्रेक, बट स्टे हियर, आई विल मीट यू राइट हियर आफ्टर दिस म्यूजिकल ब्रेक.
साड़ी जिंदगी च खास तेरी था, सोची ना तैनों दिलों कटता. लोकी हंजू आजू पढ़ लेंदे ना, ऐसे ले ऐसी रोना छड़ता, ऐसे ले ऐसी रोना छड़ता.
Thank you. ਤਨਹਾਈਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਗੱਲ ਨਾਲ ਲਾਉਣਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਲਿਆ, ਤਨਹਾਈਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਗੱਲ ਨਾਲ ਲਾਉਣਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਲਿਆ। ਲਈਏ ਡਰ ਦੇਣਾ ਕਦੇ ਤੇਰਾ ਨਾ, ਲਈਏ ਡਰ ਦੇਣਾ ਕਦੇ ਤੇਰਾ ਨਾ, ਤੇ ਹੱਥ ਵੀ ਜਤੋਣਾ ਛੱਡਦਾ।
Confusion to purchase new gadget for you, or do you want to become gadget guru? No worries, you can get all the information related to technology and lots more. Main hoon with me RJ Abdul Raza every Monday 10 PM to 11 PM only on Radio Udaan. Please log in to www.radioudaan.com.
तो अब हम पहुंच चुके हैं थर्ड सेगमेंट में, और इस सेगमेंट में हमेशा की तरह चलिए बात करते हैं कुछ मोटिवेशन, करेज, डिटर्मिनेशन एंड इंस्पिरेशनल की। तो आप सही समझे, हम बात करने जा रहे हैं एक और इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी की, और आज वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट एन इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स हीरो मोहम्मद अली। वाज इट हिज फिजिकल एबिलिटी, his social commentary, his clever cocky rhymes, or was it his post-boxing humanitarian endeavors? Maybe. It's all of the above for many who have been inspired, uplifted, and touched by the greatest champion of all time, Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali has undoubtedly been a fixture in world culture since the 1960s, seizing the gold medal at the Olympics in 1960. Battling George Foreman in the Rumble in the Jungle in Zaire and going head to head with Joe Frazier in the Thriller in Manila. In the Philippines were highlights of a career that earned Ali the status of world icon. Since his retirement in 1981, Ali has engaged in many humanitarian endeavors, including a 1990 journey to Iraq to negotiate the release of 15 hostages. In the last 20 years, Ali's cultural status has hardly diminished. 3 billion television viewers around the world watched him open the Atlanta Olympics in 1996. Inspiring billions has been a difficult work in progress for Ali. Many Americans were slighted by his brazen "I am the greatest" anthem. White America couldn't fathom a black man being so presumptuous. These same Americans were also enraged by Cassius Clay's insistence on freeing what he called his slave name for the Muslim name, Muhammad Ali. "I don't have to be what you want me to be. I am free to be what I want," Ali said of his name change. The relationship did not improve much when Ali spoke out against Vietnam, refusing to join the army during the war. His short defense, "I ain't got no quarrel with them, white conk," spoke volumes, but the media vilified him. The government prosecuted him for draft dodging, and the Boxing Commission took away his license. He was idle for 3.5 years during what should have been the peak of his career. तो आगे बढ़ते हैं और जानते हैं कि और क्या हुआ मोहम्मद अली की लाइफ में. तो जानने के लिए सुनते रहिए इंस्पिरेशनल राइट, मेरे साथ आपकी आरजे दिव्या, और मिलती हूँ मैं आपको एक म्यूजिकल ब्रेक के उस पर. हम बात कर रहे हैं एक इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी की, मोहम्मद अली की इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी की. स्टे ट्यून्ड एंड आई विल मीट यू आफ्टर दिस शॉर्ट म्यूजिकल ब्रेक.
Thank you. विनोद गुप्ता 146@gmail.com।
तो सुनना ना भूले हर मंगलवार शाम 7 से 8 पुनः प्रसारण हर बुधवार दोपहर 2 से 3। हेलो फरमाइश फरमाइश।
आज दिव्या के साथ दोस्तों शो चल रहा है इंस्पिरेशनल विंग्स और आप हैं अपने होस्ट एंड दोस्त आज दिव्या के साथ। तो चलिए आगे बढ़ाते हैं उस इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी को, इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी ऑफ मोहम्मद अली। पिछले सेगमेंट में हम थे, ही वॉज आइडल फॉर 3.5 years ड्यूरिंग व्हाट शुड हैव बीन द पीक ऑफ हिज करियर। बढ़ाते हैं आगे स्टोरी को। अलीज रिटर्न to boxing was a spectacular one. He regained his title in 1974, knocking out tough guy George in the 8th round in the famed Rumble in the Jungle. This widely publicized fight became a permanent chapter in boxing history. Ali wrote of this fight, "The Rumble in the Jungle was a fight that made the whole country more conscious." I want to establish a relationship between American blacks and Africans. All the time I was there, I would travel to the jungles, places where there was no radio or television, and people would come up and touch me, and I could touch them as well. The fight was about racial problems, Vietnam, all of that. Although the Rumble in the Jungle could not hold a touch to 1975's Thriller in Manila, a battle with Joe Frazier, which Ali also won, the Rumble in the Jungle stands out among other sporting events for its social impact and lasting effect on Ali himself. Still ferocious in the ring, Ali's meeting with the people of Africa had added another dynamic to his personality, compassion. Ali has sometimes anonymously donated millions of dollars to a variety of individuals and organizations, transcending race and class barriers. Not bad for a man maligned for his religious affiliation. In 1984, it was revealed that the man Kentucky Senate has named the greatest athlete of all time was stricken with Parkinson's disease. But true to form, Ali hasn't let his illness stop him from being free to do what he wants. Never has a sports figure inspired so many people in so many different directions. Ali has shown that a sport can be more than entertainment. It can also be a cultural event with the power to change social values. And he has shown that a black man can stand up to social oppression. तो दोस्तों ये थी एक अमेजिंग सी इंस्पायर कर देने वाली स्टोरी मोहम्मद अली की. तो इसी इंस्पिरेशनल नोट पे बढ़ते हैं आगे और अगले सेगमेंट में जाने से पहले एक छोटी सी ब्रेक ले लेते हैं. तो मिलती हूँ मैं आपको इस म्यूजिकल ब्रेक के उस पर.
कर जानना अगर ये सब क्रेजी है. हाँ मैं क्रेजी हूँ, हाँ मैं क्रेजी हूँ. किसी का दिन बनाना, खुशी ही लुटाना अगर ये सब क्रेजी है. हाँ मैं क्रेजी हूँ. Yes I'm crazy, I'm crazy, crazy crazy crazy. हाँ हाँ मैं क्रेजी हूँ. Yes I'm crazy, 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 crazy. Ha ha, main crazy hu.
Crazy, crazy.
Ha ha, main crazy hu.
Welcome back, दोस्तों. अब हम पहुंच चुके हैं इस inspirational ride के last segment में. And like always, let us take a quick look at what we have learned today. Today, in our very first segment, we talked about a story. The title of the story was, Give It a Thought. Give It a Thought. In the second segment, we talked about another story. The title of this story was, God Couldn't Stand to See Me Hurt. God Couldn't Stand to See Me Hurt. In our third segment, we talked about motivation, inspiration, courage and determination. Ji haan. We talked about another inspirational story of another personality. And today, we talked about an inspirational story of Muhammad Ali. In the fourth segment, we pursued the same story, the same inspirational story of sports hero Muhammad Ali. तो इस तरह हमारा ये एपिसोड खत्म होने पे आता है. बट बिफोर आई से गुड बाय, लेट मी रिमाइंड यू अबाउट द डिटेल्स ऑफ अवर शो. तो दोस्तों, इफ यू लाइक द अवर शो, डोंट फॉरगेट टू ड्रॉप इन योर मैसेजेस, व्यूज, सजेशंस और फीडबैक्स. फॉर ड्रॉपिंग योर आइडियाज और फीडबैक्स, visit our website www.radioudaan.com. If you are a Skype user, don't forget to add us. Our Skype ID is Radio Udaan. And if you are using Facebook, you can like our Facebook page. The URL is www.facebook.com/radioudaan. तो हमेशा की तरह I would say, try to share this information with your friends, relatives, colleagues and everyone around you. Now I have to take a leave, but before that, please note down my radio ID, divya@radioudaan.com. So now I will meet you the next Thursday, the same time 9 to 10, only on Radio Udaan. Tab tak khyal rakhiye apna, take care of yourselves, keep inspiring and keep motivating. Good luck and have a great time. Main hoon aapki host and dost RJ Divya. Goodbye and good luck. Now this last song dedicated to all my listeners. Good night.
देखता हूँ जहाँ तू ही तू ही